लगे रहो मुन्ना भाई। मम्मी मम्मी हीरो कौन है? संजय दत्त। मम्मी हीरोइन कौन है? विद्या बालन। मम्मी 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 बताओ ना, स्क्रीन पर क्या चल रहा है? क्या है? कितनी सवाल पूछती हो, चुप नहीं बैठ सकती क्या? लगता है मूवी खत्म होने तक तुम तो सवालों का पहाड़ ही खड़ा कर दोगी। खुद भी सुकून से बैठो और मुझे भी सुकून से सिनेमा देखने दो।
फाटल्या 2 वर्षाच्यान इफ्फी दृष्टिहीन लोकां खातीर स्पेशल सुविधा केल्ल्यो आसा। ह्या सुविधांचें म्हत्व म्हणजे जेन्ना स्क्रिनीर एक सीन चल्ला आनी तो सीन विदाउट डायलॉग आसा, हो सीन समजून घेवपाक दृष्टिहीन लोकांक खूब डिफिकल्ट जाता, म्हणूनच तो तांकां डिटेलान समजल्लो वयता। ह्याच निमतान नॅशनल असोसिएशन ऑफ ब्लायंडाचे सदस्य इफ्फीक आयिल्ले आनी त्या पैकी एकटो सदस्य आमच्या लागीं उलयलो।
Suction thing, what do you like?
So I believe let's concentrate on the audio display. So now this concept, from past 2 years we are having it in international film festival. This is the 3rd year. The guys involved behind getting this here is Saksham New Delhi in collaboration with CPN. The concept of accessible movie, which is the current section which is happening for persons with disabilities, is the visual impairment. Visual impairment can enjoy the movie in the same manner as we have rightly seen in these screenplay. What happens is that the silent scenes are narrated by a separate audio. For example, now I am speaking to you. Suppose mere piche kuch hai, so I will not cover it. This is the screen. So action se jo kuch ho raha hai, that is being narrated in an audio track, specifically which is called as audio description. And for persons with the hard of hearing, that is hearing impairment, closed captioning, that is subtitling, comes with the movie, so they can also enjoy the dialogues and everything. In this 50th edition, 2 movies Hindi ke hum dikha rahe hain. Today we had Lage Raho Munna Bhai, tomorrow we have Dhoni, and day after we have first Konkani accessible movie which is coming up, Crossover Their Coffee Song. So that's again a proud moment for we Govans, because we are coming on to the accessible street. So I will basically request everybody, if you all, to come and experience it in tomorrow also and day after also.
उथा सेरुप्पा साइज 7 या तमिळ फिल्माचे सिलेक्शन इंडियन पॅनोरमा सेक्शनाक झाले। ह्या फिल्माची खासियत म्हणजे पूर्ण पिक्चर फक्त एकाच मनशान केलेले आसा, बाकीचे सगळे कॅरेक्टर्स हे इमॅजिनरी कॅरेक्टर्स म्हणून आसा, तांचे फक्त आवाज येतात, ते स्क्रिनीर दिसना। ह्याच पिक्चराची अधिक माहिती दिवपा खातीर पिक्चराचो डायरेक्टर परिधान पत्रकार परिषदेन उलयलो।
मसिलामणी He's the main character. He's the main character and the only character, sir. Right? Okay. He's a middle-aged security guard at a popular sports and recreation club in Chennai. He's being questioned as a murder suspect while his terminally ill young son waits outside the investigation room. Masilamani's strange tale, with moments of unexpected comedy and sudden displays of wit, leaves us questioning who really is he. What has he done, and if he deserves the punishment that is staring him in the face? The film is about the vast rich and poor divide and the psychological stress everyone faces in life. Film entered the Asia Book of Records, yeah, and India Book of Records for having a single person writing, directing, solo acting and producing the film.
Yeah.
Mr. Parthivan is the solo actor. Is the single person writing, directing and acting in the film. Is the producer of the film too.
I tried, this is Otha Serupu. This is called Otha Serupu, a single slipper, size 7. That is the title of the film. And it's my dream. Like 15 years I am working on this script. It's a solo act film. Only one person on the screen. The rest of the characters will be on the audio, like sounds only. It's a new experience. If you Google it, you can see 12 films, the solo act films are there. Like Loki, kind of films are there. My intention was to take a world standard, international standard film. But I was working with One, Mr. Bhagiraj is a screenplay king in India. He's a writer, director. I was working with him. His style of filmmaking is totally different, but I thought my film should be like this, like Otha Serupu. It's a experimental film, but after the release, it got very good response from the audience. That is a unexpected happiness I got. It's about, it's a murder mystery happening in a one single hall. It's just 500 to 600 square feet hall, but I took 500 shots in that 500 feet square feet hall. These are all the challenges in this film. So this is about this film.
यावर्षाच्या इफ्फिक, बालाउन शोलाक आणि मॉन्स्टर ही दोन्ही पिक्चरां इंटरनॅशनल फिल्म सेक्शनान सिलेक्ट झाली. ही दोन्ही पिक्चरां कझाकिस्तानाची. त्या निमतान बालाउन शोलाकाचो डायरेक्टर नजली स्वेडगुलोव आणि मॉन्स्टरचो डायरेक्टर मारिया ऑल्टन हे दोघे जाणा प्रेस कॉन्फरन्सान उलयले.
My film talks about this couple who has been together for almost 10 years and they've been hiding a lot of things one from another in order to protect each other because they still love each other very much. And in 24 hours, the 24 hours that we see in the film, we kind of discover the end of this relationship because we get to see her part of the story, his part of the story, and then how they both understand this couple. And it is a story about tolerance and acceptance and about how much one is willing to do in order to get close and stay close to the other one. This is pretty much what the film is about.
Our movie is a historical movie, Balvan Shalak. So this is the director actually of the movie, Nurgildi Sadegulov.
Film основан на реальных событиях. Эта картина моя дебютная работа как режиссёр игрового кино. До фильма «Балан Шалак» я снимал фильмы документальные. У меня два образования. Первое образование – это режиссер документального кино. Второе образование – вот как раз это вот игровое кино. И «Балан Шалак» является моим дебютной работой.
So it's this movie is based on true events and on biography, as it was said previously, a wrestler, musician, about sacrifices which he, the name of Balvan Shalak, yeah, this nickname which the people have given, had to make. And it's debut movie of this director in feature films because previously he was actually he has been the director of documentaries. And as for his education, he's also first of all director of several documentary movies, so it's documentary. And now it's his actually debut movie if we see as feature film.
या वर्षा इफ्फीच्या निमतान कला अकादमी हांगासर डिजिटल मल्टीमिडिया एक्झिबिशन आसा. हे एक्झिबिशन 21 ते 28 नोव्हेंबर मेरेन चालू आसतले. ह्या एक्झिबिशनान विविध प्रकारच्यो टेक्नॉलॉजीज आसात. ह्या टेक्नॉलॉजीजांचो आस्वाद घेवचो अशें मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन अँड ब्रॉडकास्टिंगाचो एडिशनल सेक्रेटरी अतुल कुमार तिवारी पत्रकार परिषदेन उलयलो.
दिस टायम इट वॉज ऑल्सो द 50th इयर ऑफ द सेलिब्रेशन ऑफ इंडियन इंटरनॅशनल फिल्म फेस्टिवल. सो फॉर दॅट रिझन we have organized a very interactive digital multimedia exhibition which is just behind the next door to Kala Kala Academy, and I would invite all of you and through you all your readers to partake this situation. We organized for the children the quiz exhibition. We have taken the zoetrope, which is a new technology. We have 360 degree bullet shot. We have 360 degree immersive experience area, so when you go there, whatever you do, action like you'd have seen in a Matrix movie, just to attract the young blood. It can also be copied and given to you on WhatsApp. We have augmented reality experience where you can, children can understand how the, what all can be done by the media and entertainment. And with that, we have the whole curated history of the Indian cinema, world cinema.
Woo!
भारतीय सिनेमा आज खूप विकसित झालेलो असा. पहिलीच्या काळात बायला पिक्चरांनी काम करनासली, पण आता बायला पिक्चरांनी मेन रोल सुद्धा करपाक लागल्या. पण तरी सुद्धा बॉलिवूडान महिलांक अजूनही त्रास भोगपाचो पडटा. माकिनीज पॅलेस वन हांगासर झालेल्या इन कन्वर्सेशन सेशनान तापसी पन्नू वुमन इन लीड या विषयाचेर उलयली.
Most actors can be very wary of the negative role, like Lila Bala. I love that film.
Thank you.
And in the original film, the Spanish film, the protagonist is the negative character.
Yes, yes.
You turned it on its head and you went to Sudha and said, this is what I want to do.
Yeah.
Why?
The person who had the rights to this Spanish film reached out to me saying, this is the film. And I was, in the original film, the Spanish film, the character I played was played by a man. And my boyfriend in the film who dies, who eventually I murder, sorry for the spoiler, that character was to be played by me. That was how I was offered the film. When I saw the film, I said, can I do this voice part if you haven't casted anyone? I told this to the producer because there was no one attached to the film other than the person who had the rights and me. So when I asked him, he took a day to think. He came back and he said, okay, fine, we haven't finalized anyone. I think it's fine if you want to flip it into a woman. Because it will be interesting to see a woman, but are you sure you want to do it? I said, of course I want to do it. It's a candy for an actor to do that character. So I said yes, and then I was signed and everything. And it took us like, I think, over a year and a half or so to find a director who could do it. It probably shook me a little bit to realize that we have come to a stage where a female actor can actually say, I want this part, yeah, even though it's male's part, and flip it, and people will agree to it. But sorry to disappoint you all, let's keep the chapter a little later, because soon after, recently, I've lost a film because I'm a female actor, because they wanted a male actor, because then the budget of the film will be higher and they could spend more. So let's, we have a long way to go.
We still have a long way to go. But my next question is that, you know, we spoke about how the audience is evolving, and yes, they are. But there's certain section that still wants to see women in righteous characters.
Yeah.
Good women, bad women, nothing in between. And we have to fit into some moral compass all the time. Do you find that zone conflicting when you're picking a role like that? Like Badla, in Manmarziya, role is not evil or negative.
Yeah.
But you're very confused, doesn't know who she wants to marry. I mean, that's a big deal for us, right?
Yeah.
So, how do you pick these roles, and you know, what goes through your mind doing that?
Manmarziya again has a different story, how I said yes to it. But I'll tell you what, I think it's sari zimmedari, the whole responsibility of being the most righteous and white character. Why it has to be on the woman all the time? Either she has to be the vamp, just clearly a vamp. Or she has to be Sita Mata ka avatar all the time. No! There's a reason why Sita Mata is Sita Mata, because she's a goddess and we pray to her, and I'm not a goddess. I'm a normal human being.
No, the interesting fact is, yes, you know, great films are being made for women right now. But also the fact that A-list actors or successful, prominent actors like you and Bhumi are coming to the fore and doing some cinema together and sharing screen space.
Yeah.
The general concept is that in our industry, it's hard to get men, A-list actors to come together. Mm. You're like a movie like Mission Mangal.
Yeah.
Five women on the top.
Yeah.
So, what is the thought behind that?
So, Mission Mangal came to me much later after Sandhya, right? Because it took us like a long time to find people to do Sandhyaank. When I heard Sandhyaank's script, I actually went out to that film rather than the film coming to me, because I wanted to work with another actress at the same level. Because in my head I was thinking it would be so much fun to see two equal level actresses sharing equal screen space on screen. Around, I asked them if there's a script which has two or three female characters sharing equal screen space, because I really want to do that. When I used to see these films after going to college and all, why is always hero supposed to be doing the righteous thing and the woman is always supposed to be seeking help from the man every time, in every film, and she's supposed to be the moral support or emotional support all the time? Is it reflecting a society where, you know, in my house I see my mother doing that for my father, always in the shadow, always supporting him morally, and my dad is the bread earner of the family? Is it reflecting that? But then it has people like me also, who are like, wait, why should I just stand behind? Why can't I lead? So I was like, okay, if it has people like me and my mother both, I think it's time for people like me also to come up and be the hero of our stories. and that's when the change will happen. You know, we all इतने सालों से चलता आ रहा है यार ये एक overnight में नहीं change होता. So you need to give it time. You need to slowly let it seep in because it's a very new trend for suddenly women to take the center stage and say I am the hero of my film. I am the one who's going to be doing the job or the right or wrong whatever in the film. It's going to take time for people to digest.
इफ्फीच्या निमित्तान सिनेमा ओगींग वेगवेगळ्या प्रकारची चित्रपटां पळोवंक मेळटात. इंटरनॅशनल तशेंच रिजनल आनी शॉर्ट फिल्मां सुद्दां पळोवंक मेळटात. ह्या वर्सा गणेश शेलार हेणें डायरेक्ट केल्लें शॉर्ट फिल्म गरूड इफ्फीन सिलेक्ट जाला.
गरूड इज द स्टोरी ऑफ रोहित अ 14-year-old बॉय एंड हिज रिलेशनशीप विथ हिज मदर. द मदर कॅरेक्टर्स नेम इज लतिका. एन इन्सिडंट टेक्स प्लेस ऑन द डेथ एनिवर्सरी ऑफ हिज फादर which takes a sinister turn and changes his relationship with his mother forever.
This story is about a mother and son relationship story, and the one incident happened on the death anniversary of his father, and then suddenly the boy start looking at her mother is something differently, and then how their relationships become turbid. You know, it's a word for Marathi gadu. It's a symbolic name for their relationship we use. Like their relation is now becoming, you know, there is some turbidity it comes in their relationships. And how this, that incident's impact he has on his life. And that's the story actually. And
you can say a few words about your career as a director.
Okay. First, before I started in this film directing and writing, in just four years ago, I attended the workshop, 4 days workshop, Umesh Kulkarni's, and there they shown very good films from all over the world, the short films, and they explained to us. They explain the film how should be film how should be seen and all these things. So after that I want to do something in this film. So then I wrote my first short film called Jokhad. Jokhad means it's burden. It's available on YouTube. So that was my first effort. So at that time that short film made in 40,000 rupees. I had some friends around, and they give us money, some work for free. I had my saving also, so in that we work out. And then after that 3 years I took a very long break. I mean, it's not break, I'm exploring the things, but I didn't get anything special to tell a story. At that time, Jokhad's time, I was very impatient. So that time after that workshop, I just did that film in 3 months. So, but for Gadul, it took me almost 1 year to write a script, and then we shoot it like for 7 days, and then post production was going on till 3-4 months that film. So we worked a lot, and the budget was also little bit high. 3 lakhs was budget, so that also raised. So that in middle 3 years I done so much work on myself, you know, in the exploration, how we should see. I mean, I went into the memories of my childhood, and you know, the film, actually, if you had seen the film, there is a one chawl, and in a lower class society it happened in the chawl. The story is around that society. So I grew up in that society. So, and there are some the experiences of mine I explored, and that's the thing.
इफ्फीच्या भांगराळ महोत्सवा निमित्त आम्ही येयल्या गोवा आर्ट झोन हांगासर. आर्ट झोनांत बरेच प्रकारचे असे स्टॉल्स लागलेले आसा जे गोवा कॉलेज ऑफ आर्ट
जस्ट विद्यार्थ्यांनी केलेले असा. त्यांच्या मी मेळा आणि त्यांच्याकडल्या जाणून घेऊया की त्यांची कलाकृती ही कशी त्यांनी केली ती.
सगळ्यात पहिली आम्ही गोवा आर्ट झोनच्या हंटिंग हाऊसात गेले. या हॉन्टिंग हाऊसचे उक्तावण गोयचे मुख्यमंत्री प्रमोद सावंतान केले. थंय वेगवेगळे कॅरेक्टर्स आमकां पळोवंक मेळ्ळे. एनाबेल, जोकर, दनन अशा प्रकारचे खूप कॅरेक्टर्स आमकां थंय पळोवंक मेळ्ळे.
वी आर स्टुडंट फ्रॉम गोवा कॉलेज ऑफ आर्ट फायन आर्ट एंड वी आर इन द थर्ड इयर अप्लायड आर्ट इन द अप्लायड आर्ट सेक्शन. नाव दिस इज अ हॉन्टेड हाऊस विच इज मेड आउट ऑफ वेस्ट. इट इज वेस्ट वूड अँड युझिंग लोकल थिंग्स. नाव द होल आयडिया ऑफ दिस इज टू लेट पीपल एक्सपिरियन्स वॉट इट इज टू बी इन अ हॉरर मूवी. So we have taken stills from The Nun, The Ring, even a Marathi comic Tatya Vinsu, and we have taken a graveyard also from the movie The Mummy. Now we are 29 of us working on this project. It took us about 3.5 weeks to make this project, and it's a coordination amongst everyone, from the teachers, the staff, the principal, everyone. We have coordinated well, and this is a teamwork. It's not like, you know, 2-3 people working and the rest sleeping. We have had sleepless nights. We have been working constantly 24/7. And now my friend Ayushka, she's going to tell you more about it.
So as he said, we've been working for a very long time for this, and since IFFI has given us this opportunity to do something like this, it also helps us in our field, as in when it comes to fine arts and especially applied arts. There are many things that are related to set design, and doing something like this from scratch enables us to, you know, get a kickstart in that field, know what it is like to start from scratch, to build something like this from like basic raw material.
Hi, I'm from first year applied arts, and this is our Angry Birds stall. The whole class worked on it. So we made it because, so it's basically the actual game. So we tried to make the game in an actual form. We've put the blocks and everything, the slingshot and all. So it's actually mostly for children. Even adults can play actually. Everyone's interested to play Angry Birds these days on the phones. So we tried to make the game, and in this, it's like a very fun thing. So people come and they play, and it's for free. It's totally free. So people can come, have some fun. That's it.
We belong to Applied First Year, Goa Fine Art College, and we chose 3 mega movies of all times, Bahubali, Angry Birds and Avengers Endgame. The one behind me is Bahubali. We chose it because it's an all-time hit, an all-time favorite. Everyone loves it, almost everyone. So we decided to use the links. They're actually made heavy, so the challenge is to lift them, and if you're able to lift them, then you're a true Bahubali. Similarly, we have a bull. For kids, they can take a picture with the bull, and we have a throne, the actual replica of the Bahubali throne. So you can come, you can enjoy and feel like king for a day.
in comedy because 50 years of IFFI, so we thought that we are going to project how we have gone from black and white, from the silent eras to what we are now, which is colorful and good. So that's how we thought of projecting IFFI. So we literally chose, our theme was comedy. So we have chosen all the famous comedians and we've put their dialogues and we've also put the reel of famous movies and stuff just to project like how we have developed from 15 years and where we are now.